We present a new method for dynamically deforming facial micro-wrinkles. In previous work by Weiss et al., the appearance of human skin was greatly enhanced by simulating and generating the microgeometry of skin, the pores and wrinkles in a submillimeter range. However, such a high-resolution static microgeometry looks unrealistic when the face is deformed. This is because the stretching and compression is not modeled yet. Previously, Nagano et al. Modeled the deformation of skin via oriented 1D convolutions. The displacement map of the neutral frame is blurred in the direction of stretch and sharpened in the direction of compression. While this method can enhance the sense of motion, if you look at the corner of the mouth, many details are also blurred out. We present an alternative method to model the dynamic skin deformation that allows us to control the strength of the deformation separately for pores and wrinkles, and deform only the wrinkles that are orthogonal to the stretching. Here is for reference the same frame but without any deformation or changes to the displacement map. Here is again our method. And in motion. We built up on the wrinkle simulation previously published by Weiss et al. Here, the micro wrinkles are modeled as a graph with per edge and per node weights representing the strength of the respective wrinkle or pore. Based on this graph, wrinkles are drawn with explicit geometry into the displacement map. Similarly, pores are drawn with small geometry patches. This is the stage into which we hook into. We can control precisely how the wrinkles are drawn. Wrinkles act as a reservoir of skin under stretching. We therefore draw the wrinkles wider and shallower on stretching, and narrower and deeper on compression. For better visualization, we keep the mesh stable on the left and only show the changed displacement map. The actual motion is visualized on the right. In short, our method deforms the wrinkles already during the construction of the displacement map. In comparison, Nagano et al. Shown here to the right, take the neutral displacement map and blur or sharpen it in pixel space. Let me walk you through the pipeline in more detail. We start with generating the graph of micro details using the simulation by Weiss et al. Then, for every frame in a performance, we compute the local stress tensor similar to Nagano et al. The stress tensor describes locally the two orthogonal axes of stress and the respective stretch or compression ratio. With the stress tensor, we update the width and depth of the wrinkle and pore geometry and redraw the displacement map. A crop of an example displacement map generated in this stage is shown here on the left. Finally, the mesh is rendered with the computer displacement map and the process is repeated for the next frame. This pipeline, however, is quite costly. It requires redrawing the wrinkle geometry into a new high-resolution displacement map in every frame. We therefore propose a fast approximation of the presented method. We first split the wrinkles into bins of similar angle, and next we compute compressed and stretched versions of the wrinkles within the bin. These maps are then stored as textures on the GPU. In every frame, these maps are then blended based on the local stress tensor. This approximation dramatically reduces the time per frame from 2 seconds to around 0.05 seconds to compute 16K displacement maps. At the same time, the difference between the two methods is hardly noticeable. Previously, we introduced a fast approximation using 4 orientation bins, but how many bins are needed? Let's start with 1 bin. This works well for isotropic stretch or compression. But for anisotropic stress, the stress directions cancel out and no change is visible. Here, we need at least 2 bins. Two bins are enough for anisotropic stress in horizontal or vertical direction. For diagonal direction, two bins also don't suffice. The diagonal wrinkles are not properly animated. Now we need at least four bins. We found that this number of bins is sufficient in practice. Going to eight bins does not change the result in any noticeable way. Next, I'll show additional results on three subjects. First, I'll start with another subject singing a song. To simplify the comparison, the mesh is frozen for the zoom-ins and only the displacement maps change. In order to highlight the differences between the methods, we show the performance again with the dynamic displacement scaled up by a factor of 10. Around the chin and the nasolabial fold, you can see how our method keeps more details like the pores or wrinkles that are perpendicular to the motion during deformation. Next is a sequence of a subject performing a facial workout. At the corner of the mouth and above the lips, you can see how Nagano smooths out details and our methods preserves wrinkles parallel to the flow. Finally, we'll compare the methods on a third new subject with larger, exaggerated wrinkles. Note especially how the texture of the skin changes with a closed mouth or smile. Thank you for listening.